Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoes. Hey, you can do anything, but lay off of my blue suede shoes. Well, you can knock me down, step on my face, slam my name all over the place. Do anything that you wanna do, but honey, lay off of my shoes, and don't you step on my blue suede shoes. Hey, you can do anything, but lay off of my blue suede shoes. Go, cat! Car, drink my liquor from an old fruit jar. Do anything that you wanna do. Honey, lay off of them shoes. Now don't you step on my blue suede shoes.
All right, guys, we're here with Tommy from Big Daddy's Detail Supply. He's out of Vine Grove, Kentucky. I personally buy his products here. I'm a detailer myself, so I'm gonna have him tell us a little bit about his product. Tommy, it's good to see you today. You'll see him at all the good car shows, truck shows, he's there. So tell us a little bit about what you got here.
Most all ceramic products, got a ceramic detailer. Of course, we also have a ceramic coating kit.
I use this stuff right here. This is great.
It's a little super shine. It's like a waterless wash. Then we have a ceramic shampoo. And then the simple sealant has got all the properties of a ceramic coating, just adhered in water. So you spray it on, hose it off. There's no bunch of application to it. So real simple, good for your trailers, buses, you know, motor coaches, that type of stuff.
And as a detailer, I like simple.
I know, right? That makes it easy.
And so is this for your foam cannons
and
stuff
like that?
Yeah, that's
for your foam cannons. And, okay. You know, we have it in that size and gallon size. Of course, all of it's the same way.
I can't say enough about this product right here, guys. I use this all the time. Good stuff. Well, Tommy, I appreciate your time.
Thank
it's
you.
Always good to see you at the shows.
Man.
We'll see you next time.
Next week.
All right, man. All right, thanks.
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Too much love drives a man insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. I let you love what I thought it was funny. You came along and woo, now honey, I've changed my mind, this love is fine. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Kisses, baby, feels good. Hold me, baby. Love you like I love a shoe. You're fine, so kind. Got to tell this world that you're mine. I chew my nails down and I twiddle my thumb. I'm real nervous, but it sure is fun. Come on, baby, it drives me crazy. It's just great balls of fire. Hold me, baby. Well, I often love you like I love a sugar. You're fine, so kind. Got to tell this world that you're mine. Ain't it too much? I quit on my thumb. Real nervous, but it sure is fun. Come on, baby. Drive crazy. Goodness gracious, it's great balls of fire.
We got John from Fort Wayne, Indiana, with his awesome 72 F-100 short bed truck. He's gonna give us a little walk around on it. Come along with us. All right, John, if you could just tell us a little bit about the engine here.
Okay, it's a 2014 Ford Coyote 5.0. The folks at Brinspeed up in Syracuse, Indiana, did the build and tune. It was machined by Holbrook Machine Works out of Livonia, Michigan. The motor is got a twin turbo kit from Hellion on it. The motor's capable of up to 1,400 horsepower.
Wow.
And Hellion's given us a turbo tune for 1,000 horsepower at the rear wheels. So motor idles around 750. It's been just absolutely a piece of cake to drive around. But when you crank the boost up, you can get tons of horsepower out of it.
That's one heck of a setup there. Tell us a little bit about the fabrication. I see you got some stuff shaved, the brake drum shaved off the front there, and all kinds of good stuff.
Kevin Riffey from Riffey Hot Rods up in Knoxville, I had an idea. I wanted to get rid of the core support so that the engine was framed by the inner fender panels and the core support. So we went in, reshaped the inner fender panels to clear the turbos, built a radiator low, and then he built the panels to go over the radiator, which gives it the look of it being very clean and sanitary.
Yes, it does look clean. It's one of the cleanest trucks in here. how about this fabrication up front here?
It's all custom metalwork. That was done by Kevin. Uh-huh. All interlocking. You notice there's no fender bolts. The fender's all bowled up from the bottom. And
it's gorgeous.
The radiator, again, is hidden. On the front, if you look at the front, there's four inlets at the bottom. And those are the air inlets for the intercooler, and there's a belly pan that feeds the air up through the intercooler. We put our transmission cooler in line there, so that handles that. And then the grill is a 69 steel grill, which was offered on the base model trucks, and we reworked it to look a little more modern. Wanted it to look like it was more aggressive, more modern than the factory grills.
I love the stance on this truck. It's just wicked, mean, and nasty. Yeah.
Well, that's on a Roadster. It's on a Roadster shop chassis, which gives us the big A arms on the front with the Penske shocks and the four-link rear with the Penske shocks. Runs an aluminum center section with a 370 posi gear, and it sets right. We got it on forge line wheels. So
nice. Let's go around here and let's go check out this interior. Okay, John, if you could tell us a little bit about this interior.
Well, I wanted to do a custom interior. I'm a fairly big guy, so I wanted some room. So the guys up at Pro Auto Custom, Steve Holcomb in Knoxville, Indiana. Steve is just a magician with interiors. He's done stuff for all the big name builders. And I told him I wanted a console so that I could hide all the dash stuff, headlights, taillights, turn signals, all that stuff, or wipers, all that stuff. And then he custom built the interior. Dash has been smooth, and we used a 1964 Falcon instrument cluster. We wanted something that looked Ford, but wasn't truckish.
Right.
So,
right.
And then it's backed by Dakota Digital gauges, and their interface with the Ford Racing controller that controls the engine.
I love the way that console, the two circle. It almost looks like the back end of a Falcon, don't it?
Yeah. And they, if you look in the center, there's a round gauge. That's our turbo controls. We can raise and lower the turbo boost with that. And next to it is the shifter. Powertrain Control Solutions builds a transmission controller for the 4R70W tranny. And then we use their controller and interface it with their push-button shifter.
Oh, that is really something, John. Tell us about your wins at the Good Guy shows.
We were very fortunate. We got Builder's Choice in Raleigh and the Best Ride on a Roadster Shop chassis at Raleigh. Then we went to Des Moines later in the summer and got Best Ford Truck Pick.
Very nice, very nice. Tell us a little bit about the back of your truck. About back of your truck here?
Well, in order to get the... to hide the chassis, I wanted the bed to look like it was stock instead of being, you know, having humps in it or cutouts and stuff for the frame. So we raised the bed floor 4 inches. That also was done by Kevin. And then we doubled the tub size so we could clear the tires properly. And then wanted the bed to look stock, so we raised it 4 inches, and then we paneled it. The 72's trucks had a hollow single layer interior on the bed, so if you actually hit it from the inside, you could dent the outside. So we paneled the inside, raised the floor, and made it look like it was all stock.
Very nicely done. I mean, his work is amazing. What kind of rims are you riding on?
Those are forge-lined 12x20s on the rear with a 315 tire, and on the front is a forge-lined 19x9s with a Michelin 35 series tire on it also.
Very nice. That stance on this truck is amazing. It's been one of the showstoppers of the show right here.
If you look, we did the exhaust come out right in front of the wheels, and we did it so that it looked kind of that it fit the panel, and we surrounded it with stainless steel so that it kind of added to the look of it.
Very nice. Well, John, it's been a pleasure. Thank you for taking us around your truck here. It's surely one of the showstoppers here.
Thank you very much. Glad you could come
out. We're glad you came out, and thank you for your time today.
Thank you. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't never caught a rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine. They said you was high class. Friend of mine.